Good day, learners, and welcome to another lesson in Philippine History and Government. For today's lesson, we are going to discuss the life of Elpidio Quirino. Elpidio Quirino was born on November 16, 1890 and died on February 29, 1956. He was a Filipino lawyer and politician who served as the sixth president of the Philippines from 1948 to 1953. He was our first Ilocano president. He was then a teacher before he became a president. And he was known about his project industrialization. A lawyer by profession, Quirino entered politics when he became a representative of Ilocos Sur from 1919 to 1922. He was then elected as senator from 1925 to 1931. In 1934, he became a member of the Philippine Independence Commission that was sent to Washington, D.C., which secured the passage of Tidings-McDuffie Act to American Congress. In 1935, he was also elected to the convention that drafted the 1935 Constitution for the newly established Commonwealth. In the new government, he served as Secretary of the Interior and Finance under President Manuel Quezon's cabinet. Regarding to his focus for industrialization, when he was our president, he focused about the Angat Dam and Maria Cristina Fall Dam. After World War II, Quirino was elected vice president in the 1946 election, consequently the second and last for the Commonwealth and first for the Third Republic. After the death of the incumbent President Manuel Rojas in 1948, he succeeded the presidency. He won the president's office under Liberal Party ticket, defeating Nacionalista Vice President and former President Jose P. Laurel, as well as fellow Liberalista and former Senate President Jose Avellino. Hukba Lahat. The Hukbong Bayan Laban sa Hapon, literally People's Army against the Japanese, better known by its abbreviation Hukba Lahat or Hooks, was a socialist or communist guerrilla movement formed by the farmers of Central Luzon. They were originally formed to fight the Japanese but extended their fight into a rebellion against the Philippine government known as the Hukba Lahat Rebellion in 1946. It was put down through a series of reforms and military victories by Defense Secretary and later President Ramon Magsaysay. A monument dedicated to the Hooks in Cabillao, Nueva Ecija was constructed to honor their actions during World War II. The Quirino administration was generally challenged by the Hukba Lahats who ransacked towns and barrios. Quirino ran for president again in 1953, but unfortunately, he was defeated by Ramon Magsaysay. Post-presidency and death of Elpidio Quirino. Following his failed bid for re-election, Quirino retired from politics to private life in 1953. He offered his dedication to serve the Filipino people, becoming the father of foreign service in the Republic of the Philippines. Quirino died of a heart attack during the leap year day of February 29, 1956 at his retirement house in Novaliches, Quezon City. His remains were initially buried at the Manila South Cemetery. On February 29, 2016, his remains were relocated and reinterred at a special tomb site in the Libingan ng Mga Bayani in Taguig, in time for the 60th anniversary of his death. Once again, learners, Elpidio Quirino, our Filipino lawyer and politician who served as the sixth president of the Philippines from 1948 to 1953. Thanks for watching. See you in my next one. Please like, leave a comment, subscribe, and hit the bell button for more lessons to learn. Bye!